Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for being here today. My name is Deputy Chief Pat Ann. I'm Commanding Officer of Operations South Bureau. So all the police stations in South Los Angeles are under my command. First of all, before we start, I'd like to thank Dr. Kelvin Calloway, the senior pastor here at Bethel AME Church, for continuing to make this church available for important community meetings like this. As all of you know, LAPD investigators assigned to Robbery Homicide Division have spent years trying to solve the Grim Sleeper case. In spite of the arrest of Mr. Franklin, who lived just a short distance from this church, the investigation has continued. With us this evening are detectives who are assigned to this case. They have provided an update on the investigation and asked for additional assistance from the community to help resolve some remaining issues. Thank all of you for being here tonight. The help of the community has been very important in helping to identify dozens of photographs that were released previously. One important group that's here today that I would like to recognize is the Ceasefire Committee.
Could you, the members of the Ceasefire Committee, could you please stand up?
This is a group. This committed group of individuals, consisting of gang intervention workers, interventionists, victims' rights advocates, concerned residents, business people, meet in this church every week. This group has never shied away from challenging the police department when they think we are wrong or if they have tough questions to be answered. However, each and every day they work in our communities to reduce violence, which has saved numerous lives in South Los Angeles. And for that, we're forever grateful, and I just want to acknowledge you for that. Now it is my pleasure to introduce former chief of the Los Angeles Police Department and a current council member from the 8th District, Bernard Barnes.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chief. Good evening. How's everybody doing? Really fun being the detective chief and also the police. So thank you for bringing this case to the conclusion we have today. And I think from looking at this really a horror in our community, it's turned out to be one of the largest support in the sense of the community coming together to find a way to bring this to residents. Think about just a few months ago, they had 180 some odd unidentified photos to get down to the day where there's only 48, and to understand that that comes from community folks that are willing to step forward and to pay attention to what's going on in the community. So we're just pleased that the pastors allowed us to be here today, that we had an opportunity to, from the 8th District and also from the LAPD, to be supportive of the community's needs. And we look forward to the briefing and Detective Kilcorn, who's probably spent more time in his life on this case than probably his whole career on other cases, has brought this to a point that we believe that clearly not only are many of these cases solved, but they're on the verge of continuing to solve and bring, we won't say closure, but certainly giving families a sense that they know the conclusion, they know where their loved one is, and they can certainly begin to start the grieving process. So I'm pleased to be here and look forward to continually working with Chief Beck and LAPD in any way that we can on this case and those other cases that affect the agencies. So thank you very much for being here.
We actually owe Councilman Parks a big debt of gratitude. As this case continued to I don't want to say drag on, but as it continued to be worked and as his detectives continued to work it, Councilman Parks never forgot about this investigation, continually supported it, worked with investigators on ways in which we could get our information out publicly in many different ways, and we're very appreciative of that. Councilman, thank you. Now it is my pleasure to introduce the Chief of the Los Angeles Police Department, Charlie Beck.
not only to this community, but to these families to my right. 28 years is the span of Lonnie Franklin's criminal endeavors. 28 years. So far, we've accounted for 16 lives that he took during those 28 years, and two people who he tried to murder. All of this occurred blocks from this house of worship where we sit right now. And this community and this police department never gave up on those victims. Never. And we never will. We may never know how many young women Lonnie Franklin killed, but we're going to do our best to find out. And we're going to do our absolute best to make sure that every family, that every friend, that every fellow community member knows that justice is being done as well as human beings can do it. Former Chief Parks and Chief Gannon are absolutely right. We can never give closure. We can never right completely the wrong that has been done, not only to these families, but to this community. But we can do the best that we can do. And we can make sure that everybody understands that every life is of equal value. That there is no hierarchy in the investigation of murders in the Los Angeles Police Department. Every human life deserves the best that all of us can do. So I want to thank my detectives who have devoted their lives, their professional lives to this. I watched them, you know, when I was chief of detectives, and this case had not been solved yet. I watched them sweat and grieve and fuss over it every day. And I was quite sure that they would never leave. They would never leave their assignments until this case was solved. So excuse me. So I know how much it means to them. And I certainly know what it means to the families. As I have met with them on multiple occasions during this investigation. Thank you all for your help. Please, to the media, please take from this the importance of those 48 photos. You know, we have shown through the investigation that has taken place since the arrest of Mr. Franklin that those photos mean something. That there are victims in those photos, victims' faces in those photos. And we need to identify as many more as we can. So please focus on that. Detective Kilcoyne is going to come up and give you a briefing on the case status. Some details can't be made public, but he's going to do the best he can to let you know what is available. So thank you all again.